magkabi ng panig.
If we'll be given the opportunity, Your Honor, we will do so.
Kung ipagpahintulot po ninyo, Ginoong Pangulo.
Ang prosecution.
Opo, doon po sa sinabi ni kagalang-galang Senador Lacson, kumporme po kami doon yung mga warrantless searches po yon. Pero dito po ay nag-issue po mismo ang Senado ng subpoena. So maliwanag po ito, nakapangyarihan ng Senado ang mag-issue ng subpoena. At nung in-issue po yung subpoena, very particular po, hindi po general subpoena ito dahil pirmado po ng Ginoong Pangulo po ito. Subpoena ad testificandum ad duces tecum dated February 6. Napakaliwanag po dito, sabi po dito, to bring with you the original and certified true copies of the opening documents for the following bank accounts, numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10 accounts po. In the name of Renato C. Corona and the bank statements showing the year-end balances for the said accounts as of December 31, 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010. Ang pinagbabawal po ay yung, sabi po nga ni Justice Cuevas, yung pangkalahatan po na warrant na kung ano-ano na lang ang padadala mo dyan at bahala ka ng magkalap doon o ano. Dito po napaka specified po eh, napakaliwanag po, kaya it conforms with the constitutional mandate that the warrant or the warrant, search warrant should describe with particularity ang liwanag po. Napakaliwanag po. At isa pa po, nung na-issue po itong warrant, meron naman pong remedyo yung kabila na pinakwas sana ito kung mali yung subpoena po. Kung talagang ang sa tingin nila eh labag ito sa saligang batas, dapat pinakwas po nila yung subpoena. Hindi po eh, tumahimik po sila. At sa katotohanan po, eh kinos-examine pa nila yung witness, pati yung mga dokumento. Nandito po sila. At ang ating jurisprudence po, yung pagkakamali ng abogado, eh talagang the client is bound by the mistake or lapses. Papatawad po ninyo ha. Kung, kasi po, hindi naman po nila in-object. Pwede naman po nilang pakwas. Katulad po yung isang subpoena po namin ngayon, ino-object po nila, kaya hanggang ngayon, hindi pa po natin nadidesisyonan. Pero ito po eh, talagang inisyo ng Senate President, wala pong umangal sa mga miyembro, wala rin pong umangal sa mga partido, at sa katunayan po, lahat po ng tinawag na mga dokumento dito, napasok na po, namarkahan na po namin, kaya sa tingin po namin, nandun po, hindi lang po presumption of regularity, nung pagka-issue ng Ginoong ng kagalang-galang na Senado, kundi tumalima na rin po yung kabilang partido dito po sa subpoena ito.
Ang depensa?
If Your Honor, please, I'm sorry to dissent from the opinion of the honor and comment made by the Honorable Counsel for the prosecution, Your Honor, because we have on record, Your Honor, a consolidated opposition and rejoinder which we filed February 6th and we have a copy thereof questioning the legality of the issuance of the subpoena which had been issued by this Honorable Court. Now, the subpoena in question now, Your Honor, is the subpoena requiring the appearance and production of the various documents mentioned in here, which is into the which appearance and production must be made at 2 o'clock in the afternoon on the 14th day of February 2012. We did not have the opportunity even to object, Your Honor, much less a motion to quash. We are preparing it, and with the kind indulgence of this Honorable Court, we will be filing it today, Your Honor. So, time constraint forbids us from immediately acting on this motion, Your Honor. Now, we do not question, I hope we will not be misunderstood, Your Honor, we do not question the authority of this impeachment body, Your Honor, to issue the subpoena prayed for, Your Honor. But since this is duces tecum, not only testificandum, there must be a showing of the materiality, relevancy of the document sought to be produced. And that otherwise it will be considered as oppressive and to the detriment of the impeached public officer because it is a violation of his right to due process, Your Honor. Why do we say so? A mere examination of the subpoena in question, Your Honor, will sustain or lend credibility to our postulation, Your Honor. It mentioned any and all peso savings account. current accounts, time deposit, certificate of deposit, settlement accounts, investment fund, management and trust fund, unit investment trust fund, mutual funds, and any and all other financial instruments. Is that not convincing enough to show that this is equivalent to a general search warrant, Your Honor? What, for instance, are the materiality of this document? What are they in the first place? Will they be relevant or material to the issues involved? The way we understood this, Your Honor, as we go along trial of this impeachment case, this is merely in support or in connection with paragraph 2.2 and 2.3, and never on the issue of ill-gotten wealth provided for and spoken under 2.4, Your Honor, because there is already a resolution of this Honorable Court that the prosecution is debarred or prevented or hindered from presenting evidence towards that end. That ruling had never been modified, much less revoked or withdrawn by this Honorable Court. It is along those lines that we submit, Your Honor, that this is practically the equivalent of a general search warrant, giving all the leeway and paving the way for grave abuse of discretion on the part of the party serving the subpoena to compel the production of this document. If this is served upon member, for instance, of the prosecution, what documents will they present? What year and so on? And what is the purpose, Your Honor? Because it is not enough that there is a subpoena. That is beyond dispute, Your Honor. We never question the right and authority of this impeachment court to issue the subpoena. It has the power to. But in the exercise of that power, it must be within the prerogatives, within the ambit of our constitutional provision, Your Honor, that had been succinctly declared and it had been indelibly discussed in the case of Francisco et al. Versus the Honorable Court of Appeals. We submit, Your Honor. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President.